गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वंस अगेन माई सेल्फ निरंजन कुमार। इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स एंड देयर सोर्सेज। इन दिस पीरियड वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज, यूजेस, डिस्प्लेसमेंट रिएक्शन, करोजन ऑफ डिफरेंट एलिमेंट्स। एट फर्स्ट we will discuss about chemical properties of metals and non-metals. In chemical properties, that means reaction with different elements. So in this properties, we will discuss about reactivity with air, reactivity with water, reactivity with acid and bases. At first, reactivity with air. Air, that means oxygen, can react both metals and react non-metals. At first, metals. So metal react with oxygen to form metal oxide, and non-metal react with oxygen to form non-metal oxide. That means both metal and non-metal react with oxygen. Metal plus oxygen, like sodium, react with oxygen to form sodium oxide. Magnesium react with oxygen to form magnesium oxide. So metal react with oxygen to form metal oxide. But there are some exceptional. That means if we see the reactivity series, so some elements that lower down the hydrogen, that means copper, mercury, silver, platinum, gold, these are less reactive elements. Especially gold, platinum, silver, very less reactive. They do not react with air. That means exceptions are gold, platinum, silver. They do not react with air. While some metals like sodium, potassium are highly reactive. They have so reactive as they can catch fire when they are kept in open. So these are highly reactive metal, while silver, platinum, gold are less reactive metal. They cannot react with oxygen. So metals which can react with oxygen to form metal oxides, and metal oxide, while non-metal react with oxygen to form non-metal oxides. Exception are silver, platinum and gold. Now second reaction is reactivity with water. So reactivity with water, there are also different conditions. Like some metals that are highly reactive metals like sodium and potassium can react with cold water. But copper, mercury, silver, platinum, gold cannot react with water even in a steam or hot water. While some metals react with hot water, but they cannot react with cold water. So there are different conditions in reaction of water. Some highly reactive metal like sodium and potassium has ability to react with cold water, while copper, silver, mercury, gold cannot react with water in any conditions. While some metals like magnesium is also react with water, but cannot react with cold water, but it can react with hot water. Then we go to other element in less reactivity series, zinc, iron. Zinc is less reactive than magnesium. So zinc can react with water, but not hot or cold water. they can react with a steam. So there are different conditions. The highly reactive metals in reactivity series like sodium and potassium can react with cold water. Calcium cannot react with cold water. Magnesium cannot react with cold water. They can react with hot water, while other less reactive zinc cannot react with even with hot water, but it can react with a steam. While in lower down of reactivity series like copper, silver, mercury, platinum, gold, they cannot react even with a steam in any conditions, in any water. But more thing is that any water, any metal that can react with water, hydrogen gas will produce. So metal react with water, metal oxides or metal hydroxides are formed, and both conditions hydrogen gas will be produced. Like sodium react with water, sodium hydroxide is produced and hydrogen gas is also formed. Magnesium react with water, magnesium oxide is formed and hydrogen gas is produced. But magnesium react with hot water, not cold water. While non-metal do not react with water. Non-metal actually only react with oxygen. Non-metal cannot react with water. Non-metal cannot react with acids, and reaction with base is very complicated. It can be studied in further classes. Now third one is reactivity with acid. In acid, same like reaction with water, hydrogen gas is also produced. So metal react with acid. Acid, there are two types of acid, mineral acid and organic acid. So in reaction we will discuss only organic mineral acid. Organic acid cannot react with metal. So only organic acid, or especially dilute organic acid, not concentrated. Dilute means the acid that contains more amount of water, while concentrated means acid which contains very little amount of water. So dilute acid can react, dilute mineral acid can react with metal, and during the reaction of metal with dilute acid, metal salt and hydrogen gas will produce. And in same reaction with water, all metals cannot react with acid, like silver, platinum, gold are very less reactive metals. They cannot react with acid, in any acid. In this reaction only three acids are used: sulfuric acid, hydrochloric acid and nitric acid. So these dilute acids are used to react with water, metals, while non-metals cannot react with even hydrochloric, sulfuric and nitric acid. So metal react with acid to form metal oxide, like magnesium react with hydrochloric acid, magnesium chloride is formed and hydrogen gas will produce. Exceptions are mercury, platinum, gold. These are less reactive metal, they cannot react with acid. Here one more important thing is that like silver and gold, less reactive metal, they cannot react with acid, but a solution is used to clean the ornament, that is known as aqua regia. It is a solution of हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड एंड नाइट्रिक एसिड इन रेशियो ऑफ 3:1. दैट मीन्स 3 parts ऑफ डायल्यूट हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड रिएक्ट विद 1 part ऑफ नाइट्रिक एसिड टू फॉर्म एक्वारियर. इट इज ए सॉल्यूशन दैट हैज एबिलिटी टू क्लीन द ऑर्नामेंट मेड ऑफ सिल्वर और गोल्ड. सो गोल्डस्मिथ यूज दिस सॉल्यूशन टू क्लीन द ऑर्नामेंट मेड ऑफ गोल्ड एंड सिल्वर. नेक्स्ट वन इज द रिएक्शन रिएक्टिविटी विद बेस. नॉर्मली वेरी लिटिल अमाउंट ऑफ वेरी लेस मेटल्स कैन रिएक्ट विद बेस. Especially aluminium has ability to react with base, but other elements, other metals cannot react with base. Now, one thing is that displacement reaction. Displacement reactions, as we see that reactivity series in top. There is very less reactive metals. As we go down, the reactivity is lower down, and in bottom there is least reactive metals. So when a solution which contains less reactive metal is react with highly reactive metal, as for example zinc is react with copper sulfate. So copper is less reactive than zinc. In reactivity series, we can see that zinc is more reactive and copper is less reactive. So, when we react zinc with copper sulfate, the copper will displace from this solution. That means copper will displace from copper sulfate. A new compound zinc sulfate is formed and copper will displace. So the reaction in which any less reactive metals will displace by highly reactive metal from its solution is known as displacement reaction. So displacement reaction is the reaction in which highly reactive metal displace the less reactive metal from its solution and form a new compound. So this is known as displacement reaction. One thing is that corrosion. Corrosion means making a layer of any substance over the metals. As we can see that iron rust. Rust is formed when iron reacts with moist air. So other substances that are especially in highly reactive, they can react air, water, acid. That means the corrosion may take place of the substances. So formation of another layer over the metal is or any other substances is known as corrosion. So corrosion can be prevented by some steps, by some ways. That means we can prevent the substances from its corrosion by using the paint, by oiling them, by making the alloys, or one thing is that by mixing toward different substances, that is known as electroplating or galvanization. Galvanization means making a layer of zinc over the other substances is known as galvanization, while making the layer of other substances over the iron object is known as electroplating. So corrosion can be prevented by using the paint, by oiling them, by making the alloy, or by electroplating or galvanization process. Alloy is common use that like magnet is used, that is Ameco is alloy, that is used to make magnet. Same is bronze, zinc are alloys. Steel is alloys. Stainless steel is alloys that are used to prevent the corrosion or used to properties of different substances. At last, we will discuss about the uses of metals and non-metals. Uses of metals and non-metals. Metals and non-metals both are used in many ways. They are used in our daily life activities. As for example, we can see that at our homes, many equipment, many substances are made of iron, aluminium. So iron is most usable substances. They are used in construction of buildings, construction of roads, rails or bridges. Like vehicle parts is also used, the iron is used in vehicle parts. Same ways, nails, other substances, other equipments are used in agriculture activities are made of iron. Same ways, aluminium that is used in container, in utensils used at our homes. Same ways, mercury is a metal that is used in thermometer, barometer. Copper is used in electric wiring. Aluminium is used in electric wiring. So many types of metals are used in different ways. Same ways, non-metals are also used as oxygen, that is supporter of life. They can use to breathe in the photosynthesis. Carbon dioxide is used by the plants in the respiration. Oxygen gas is used by all living organisms. Other carbon is used in cell or battery like graphite. Also diamond is used to cut the substances that are made of carbon. Same ways, sulfur, phosphorus, other non-metals are used in different ways. So metals and non-metals are used in our daily life activities, at our homes, in industries or in different purposes. So these are the very important substances in our life. This chapter we will study in detail in also class 10.